I say, I have so many butterflies inside my stomach now. Because I don't know what to say and I don't know what how to start after hearing so many achievements there and there. I have nothing in there. I have my papers. I write my speech here, but they say, you cannot read that. You have to speak by yourself. But may I say, will you permit me to read a bit? Kasi hindi ko siya matandaan. But I know everything in here. Kaya lang, siyempre, at my age, you don't expect me to memorize everything in here. But I can say to you, I am the one who wrote this. My daughter is the one who computerized this because I don't know how to use the computer. Because, may I introduce my son? Moses Pingad, he told me that after my speech, some kind of suhol. Sabi niya, Ma, meron akong computer, bibigay sa'yo mamaya. O, magpatututo na rin ako niyan kasi tuturuan ako ng anak ko. He is a CPA. May I introduce my son, Mr. Moses Pingad. Moses, stand up. Stand up! Maybe something is happening to me now. I am so nervous to tell you the truth. To all of you, VIPs and I are in one accord of imparting something very special. But before that, allow me to greet everyone. Guten Tag. Guten Tag is a German word, means good day. But I'm still speaking to you. At the time that I had received the invitation to be one of the speakers today, I had a lot of thoughts of what kind of story I would like to share. How and where to begin it, because as of now, I am a student, as they said. I am a sophomore in Laguna State Polytechnic University. How come at my age I am still studying? Because everybody that I met at my age, sabi nila, bakit mag-aaral ka pa? Ay, 67 years old ka na. Eh, hindi ka pa natatapos, eh, retired ka na. Hindi ka ba nagtatrabaho, kick out ka na? Sabi ko, hindi, gusto ko lang kasi malaman. Meron lang ako, I want to prove something for myself that even at my old age, I can study, I can say something to you worthy of your listening, and I can impart to you what is my advocacy. But before that, may I say something about myself again? I am Mrs. Mercedes Gonzalez Pingad from Real Calamba, Laguna, Laguna Province. And I am married to only one man, Mr. Ventura Pingad. And he is an engineer also in Cagayan Valley. We produce 7 good children. My husband is a very good husband, a very good provider. He makes them all study. He works very hard for all of my children, and because of that, he died. But I am not happy that he died. I said he died because of too much work, too much saving money for the children. He is really a good provider and he is really a good husband. Kasi tingnan nyo, di ba, kahit matanda na ako, maganda pa rin ako. Kasi Hindi ako nahirapan talaga. He is a good provider. He is a good father. He is a good husband. Kaya pito ang naging anak namin. He is a very good provider of my love life. And I love him also till the day he died. Then when he died, I am virtually alone. Alone. I feel so mad. Very, very alone. And that is not the end of my happy life. Say. Kasi, I said to myself, why am I like this? I don't want this. I want to study. And then somebody in my church, Kabuyao Church, introduced the alternative learning system. And when the wife of the pastor says, sino gustong mag-aral uli? Walang bayad. Eh di tumaas ako ng kamay. Ayaw nilang maniwala na hindi ako nakapag-aral kasi hindi raw halata. Eh, sabi nila, Ninang, totoo bang hindi ka nakakapag-aral? Hanggang second year lang ako, high school. So, I accepted the challenge of alternative learning system through the auspices of Sir Ronnie Villanueva and Ma'am Charito Pangdalan, and the district supervisor was East, Sir Orly Valverde and Ma'am Cha Pangdalan. And they are all the people that I'm grateful because of my studies. Every week, they will give me modules. And then every week, I will study the modules. And every week, I will return the modules with my answers. And every week, they will check it. I do that for 10 months. 10 months, third year and fourth year high school. Because as you see, I stopped studying 1959. When I begin studying again the modules, I seek the help of my children and the computer. And all of my children were supportive of me. They teach me, they give me the answer, and then every week I will return the module and the teacher will check it. It is all right. But, to tell you the truth, I am really studying. I don't allow myself to be idle. They will be the one who will search in the computer. I will be studying, I will memorize it. And then when time comes, at the accreditation and equivalency period in Baay, Laguna, we are 30 people who took the exam, only 4 passed. And I am included in the 4 people who passed the exam. And then, the teachers told me, Mami Ched, tutuloy ka pa? Aba, oo. Parang nagtataka sila, nung nag-aral ako ng alternative learning system, nahihirapan na kayo kasi English yung sinasabi ko. Tatagalugin ko. Noong 2005, nag-aral ako, 65 years old ako. So, nakagraduate ako ng 10 months, 2006. So, 2007, nag-exam ako nag-entrance exam ako. I took the entrance exam at Laguna State Polytechnic University. And the teachers and the dean there, looking at me like that, Ma'am, where is your daughter or your son to be enrolled? So, ma'am, I am the one who will take the exam. Eh, di ganun uli. Sabi nila, eh, kaya niyo pa ba ho ba? Abay, bakit naman ho, hindi? Eh, kaya nga ho ako naandito, gusto kong mag-aral eh. Is it not that age doesn't matter when it comes to education? Eh, di... Narinig pala nung isa sa mga deans na kinuwestiyon ako ng ganon. Napagalitan siya. Sabi, bakit? Eh kung gusto bang mag-aral ng matanda, eh di pabayaan mo. Tapos, when I am studying and I pass the entrance exam, to tell you the truth, I really answer the questionnaire. And it took me only 15 minutes to answer all of that. That's the truth. And when I look at them, when I am going out, dahil tapos na ako, sabi ko, bakit itong mga ito hindi pa tapos ang babae? Sabi ko, nag-isip tuloy ako, siguro nga talagang meron akong brain. Brain, the neurons. Nung nag-aaral na ako, nung pumapasok na ako, di wala pa akong uniform. All the drivers, all the bus drivers, all the tricycle drivers, tinatanong ako, "Ma'am, saan kayo pupunta? Sa LSPU? Teacher ho ba kayo?" Hindi pa, nag-aaral nga eh. Tapos nung pinag-uniform na kami, sabi ng teacher si Ma'am Pamulaklakin, "Mami, mag-uniform ka? Oho, what you can do, I can do better. What you can wear, I can wear better." O, di ba, mas maganda ako. Nung naka-uniform na ako, sabi lalo ng mga driver, talagang, yung lahat ng nilalakaran ko, ganun sila. Hanggang sa may nahulog sa pavement. Nahulog, siguro katitingin, hindi na nakita na dulas na pala siya. Sabi ko, magtanong ka kasi, huwag kang basta tingin ng tingin. Tanungin mo, hindi ako nababaliw. Kasi meron nagsabi, siguro isa yan sa mga nakakawala. Not knowing that I am really a student. Sabi kong ganun, aba, ay, ako yung nag-aaral talaga, ay kahit ba anong tingin nyo sa akin eh, di ayos lang. Basta't ako'y mag-aaral. At tingnan ninyo, after 4 years, kung sino yung teacher, ikaw driver pa rin, ako teacher na. Kasi, para bang ang sakit pakinggan yung, bakit yan, nag-aaksaya ng oras? Ay, hindi ako nag-aaksaya ng oras, I am studying. Mas masarap pakinggan yung, uy, bakit yung matandang yun nag-aaral kesa nagtotong it. To tell you the truth, my teachers, all professors in LSPU, they acknowledge my studying there at LSPU because pag meron kaming affair, kasali ako, nagsayaw na ako ng karinyosa sa school namin, at kasali rin ako sa PE. Hulaan nyo, ano yung PE ko? Swimming! Nakabating suit, ang lola nyo! Two-piece. Pero hindi yung ano, hindi yung mala Angel Locsin, mala Gina Pareño na ngayon. Pero to tell you the truth, this is me again. I am really proud to study. At I am teaching people without them knowing na I am teaching them how to be courteous and how to be polite. And my advocacy is for you, all people of this place. I know you are rich. I know you are rich in experience like me, and I know you have many people that you know in education. Please tell them to accept my invitation to see my school, and then you will see that many children, many young people who are not studying because of lack of money, lack of funds. The teachers there says to me that, "Will you please, Mama Ched, tell the people of, may I say, President Noynoy Aquino, if he is not here, that please increase the budget of the teachers, the university teachers. Because, as I have said to you, I want to be a teacher and I don't want to live in very meager income." 2 years from now, I will be marching in my university and I will be receiving my diploma that I am teacher in Bachelor of Science in Fisheries Education. And I will teach, kahit ayaw nila, magtuturo ako kasi yun ang aking advocacy. Gusto ko talagang yung hindi ko nagawa nung young people pa ako kasi siyempre, some unavoidable circumstances have happened to me. Nag-asawa ako ng bata, nagkaanak ng marami. O di siyempre, paaalagaan mo yan, papaaralin mo yan, papakainin mo yan. E di, naubos ang oras ko sa kanila. No, sir? Naubos ang oras ko sa kanila, ay di, nung lahat sila itapos na, nagtatrabaho na, you feed me, you educate me, and gastusan niyo ako ngayon. Yung ginawa namin ng tatay mo sa inyo nung araw na alam ko, nangungupit kayo. Ngayon, nagpapasobra din ako. Pag sinabi ng teacher ko, Ma'am Ched, kasi ang pangalan ko sa school ay hindi Mercedes, Ched, Commission on Higher Education. Mami Ched, ano ang baon mo ngayon? Abay, wala ho akong baon. Ang baon ko'y pera. Galing sa mga anak ko. Ang sabi ko sa kanila, pag ako'y nag-aral, walang tutol-tutol. Pag sinabi ng mga teacher ko na 5,000 ang babayaran, ginagawa kong 6,000. May kupet na 1,000. And now, siguro naman naintindihan niyo ang gusto kong sabihin sa inyo. Natulungan ninyo ako na ma-educate din yung mga young people na hindi na nakakapag-aral. Maybe somebody here will hear my plea that sabihin nyo naman kay Noy-Noy, dagdagan ng budget ng mga teachers. Siguro, yun lang ang kaya kong sabihin kasi hindi naman ako scientist like ma'am. Hindi rin ako, ano nga sa'yo? Basta, hindi ko ma-express ang feeling ko na I am here standing in front of you, a 67-year-old woman still studying, but I can talk to you freely because nobody can sumaway sa senior citizen na magsalita kasi merong senior citizen expanded senior citizens act. Nabasa ko yon sa Los Baños na kung gusto ng matanda mag-aral, kung gusto ng matanda magtrabaho at kung kaya pa, siguro naman ikaya ko pa kasi nakatayo pa ako dito kahit ninenervyos ako. I can graduate and I can teach and I can gather many children in my neighborhood just like you gather me here. You bring me here, Sir Yubienko. The ABC of my life is A, alternative. L, learning. S, system. That's where I came from. Alternative learning system. And now my alma mater is ALS. And to be alma mater is LSPU. Thank you.